The Legend of Sleep Hollow by Washington Irving. Fells of the late Diedrich Knickerbocker. A pleasing land of drowsy head it was, of dreams that wake of shut eye, and of the castles in the clouds that was flushing out a summer sky. That's for muscle of indolence. In the bosom of one of those spacious coves which indent the eastern shore of the Hudson, at that broad expansion the river denominated ancient Dutch navigators and sea, and they always prudently shortened and invoked the protection of Saint Nick crossed their last market town, or by which some Greensburg and Proctor. This name was foretold in the good housewife adjacent country, from the errant propensities to linger market. Be that as I do not vouch for the merely the sake of being precise and authentic. This village, perhaps about, there is a rather land amongst, which is best placed. A small brook, with just a murmur to lull one to repose, occasional whistle or tapping of a wood most the breaks in warm tranquility. I recollect that, when a stray first explored in squirrel shooting was in nut trees, one side of the valley, I had wandered into a noontide when all peculiar it, and was startled by the roar of my as it broke the sad still mound and what the angry echoes. If I should wish for a retreat, whither I rolled in its distract a troubled lamacy from the listless and peculiar character who are descendants of old Dutch settlers, this sequestered glen has long the name of Sleep, and its rustic lads are called throughout all neighboring country. A drowsy dreams to hang over and to pervade the atmosphere. Some say that the place was bewitched by German doctors during the early days of others, that an old American, the prophet or wizard, has trailed his powwow before the country was discovered by Master Hickon. Certain it is, the place still continues under the sway of some witching powell to spell over the minds of the good people, causing them to walk around in a river. They are given to all kinds of marvelous belief, are subject to trances, visions, and frequently strange sights, and hear and voices in the air. The whole neighborhood abounds with old tales, haunted spot, and twilight superstitions. Stars shoot, and meteors glare, oftener across the valley than any other part of the country, and then whole mold seems naked. The dominant spirit haunts this enchanted region, and seems to be the chief of all others in the is the apparition figure horseback without. It is said by some to be the ghost of a Hessian whose head had been carried away a cannonball in sumless battle during the Revolution, and who was up and anon by the country hurrying along in the gloom of night, as if on the wings of his haunts not confined to the valley, but extend at times to the adjacent road, and especially to the vicinity of a church at no great distance. Indeed, certain most authentic historians of those who have been careful collecting and collects concerning the specter allege that the having been pillaged, the ghost rust of his head, and with that rushing speed he sometimes passes like a is owing to him beloved and in a to get back to the churchyard daybreak. Such is the general purport of the superstition which has furnished material to storing of shadows. The specter is no country firesides of the horseman of Sleep. It is remarkable the visionary propensity is not confined to the inhabitants of the village. Is unconscious by everyone who resides there at times. Wide awake they may have been, they entered that sleep, are sure, in a little time, to inhale the witchy, begin to grow imaginative, to dream dreams. See, Rishan, I mention this piece with all possible love. It is in search, such little retired Dutch fat in there, bosomed by the great state of elation and customs from the great torrent of aggression and improvement, which is in such incessant changes in other parts of this restless sweeps by unlike those little nooks of still. Which border around where we may see in bubble riding quilt or slumic or undisturbed by the rot. Years have elapsed since the drowsy shades of Sleepy Hollow. Yet I question I should not stain trees, vegetating shell bosom. And this by place or abode in a world of American history is to say some 30 years since a worthy looked by the Icaposo George. He expressed it, tarry and sleep. Of instructing the child. He was of Connecticut, a state which supplies the youth with partners for mind as well as for and sends forth its legions of in country schools. The cognomat inapplicable to his part. He was tall, but exceedingly with narrow shoulders, and arms and legs, hands that filled a mile of his sleeves, feet that might have served for shovels, and his whole frames loosely held together. His head was small at the top, with huge ears, large green glassy antlers, so that it looked like a weather perched upon his spindle neck, which wind blew to see him strike of a heavy day with his clothes bagging and taken for the genie descend some scarred. His mouth was all built in stalks, a glaze stretched with leaves of wood. It was mostly secured at vacant. By a twisting of the door, sticks set against the window shutter, so that, though it did with perfect ease and some embarrassment, an idea most borrowed by the architect, Houghton, from the mystery of the pot, rather but a situation, a step of woody hanging close by birch tree, it, with his voices, cottons might be heard in a drowsy summer's day, like the hive bees of the master, in the tonus or commander adventure, in sound of the bird, urged some tar loitery. He was a conscientious and ever-exam, spit and spoil the child, Ichabrain scholars, sir, not spoiled. I would not have imagined he was one of those quintets of the school in the smart of their subject. On the contrary, minister justice with discrimination other than severity, taking them off the backs of the weak, and knit on those of the strong. Your knee's type was stretched at the least flourish of the was past Belgium. The claims of justice were satisfied. Like this way, which is needed, the word of God on top of head will have a wonderfully is generally of some importance in a female ever but being considered a kind of idle, gent-like perch, really superior taste and blushments to the and endearance there is occasion little stir us the addition of a soupy dish of cakes or advent of a silver tea. There's their happy in the smell of the country damsels. Well, he would figure among the churchyard between surveys, gather grapes from the wild vine and the surrounding tree, recite their amulet loves on the tombstone, or sauntering with the hanks of adjacent milk, bashful cobumpkin hung sheepishly in his soup elegant and address. From his lap also, kind of drowning gazette, the whole budget of Olga's house to house at his appearance was all with satisfaction and as an addition, for he looks quite through master history of which by fact and a mixture of small shrewd credulity, his appetite for hours of digesting extraordinary an increase in this spell region. No tale was too monstrous for his, but you can it was often after his school afternoon, just a rich bed, his conover starved tale until the gap of aid, the printed bazaar and strength. To the happened to be bound of nature, excited imagination of the whippoorwill from the hay, the budding cree-toad, the dreary of the screech out the sun, the thicket of wind from there was too kissed as one of unless would streak by chance, blockhead beetle in his blundering light again, the point to give up the ghost, he was struck which is token resource on occasions, or drugs was to sing tunes, and or off it his nasal and linked sweetness walked along the dusty of his. his sources was to pass long Dutch walk, spinning by the apples, and listen to their mustanged goblins, haunted belts, haunted bridges, haunted houses, particular snake galvation. Portion, wrong Dutch urchin, who sulk and swell, who dogged and sullen. All this he called his duty either, and he never inflict a chastisement without assurance. So go solitary to the guardian who would remember it and thank him. Longest day, when school hour and planet of large, and on holiday months would con pretty sisters of good housewives for mothers, noted for the comforts of the cupboard. Indeed, it behooved him to keep on good terms, coming arriving from his school, and he would have scarcely sufficient to fret, for he was a huge thief, the leading powers of Mondo, but to help, according to country in those parts, boarded at the houses of the farmers, whose children instruct. With these he lived successfully, getting thus gowns of all his work in a cotton handkerchief. That all this might be to a person of his rustic friends, who are apt to consider us of school leave his burden, and schoolmaster's essence, he had rendering himself useful, and he assisted the farmers again, lighter of their helped mended the fences, horses to walk the cows from pasture, and cut wood for the winter. He laid aside, too, all the dignity, absolute sweat with which in his little empire, and became gentle species of the mother, particularist, and like the lion bull, which magnanimously the lamb did, he would sit with a child and rock a cradle hours together. In addition to his sons, he was the singing master of it, and picked up 8 shillings and strokes in song. It was a matter of to him on Sunday, his station in Churchgate, with a chosen he completely caring from the person. Sir voice was asked of the con peculiar stature, which may even hide of the little son, which are said legitimate of